Firstly, it got the title of the video wrong. I gotta say, not a good start. Are you a content creator wanting quick feedback on your YouTube videos? Or perhaps you're looking for an easy way to get a summary of a useful video you've watched? Well, stick around and I'll show you how to get summaries and feedback on YouTube videos with Google's Gemini. Hi, I'm Ramnexus. I've had a YouTube gaming channel for about 18 months now, and I'm always looking for ways to improve the quality of my next video. So I spent the last week experimenting with Google Gemini to see how useful its reviews of my videos were and if it had any useful advice for me. Today, I'll show you what I learned after Gemini reviewed one of my most watched videos. I'll explain how useful I found it. Importantly, I'll show you some of the errors it's made. And as we go along, I'll give you some tips to help you get the most out of Gemini. Sound good? Right, let's do this. So what is Google Gemini? Gemini is a generative AI chatbot. It's similar to OpenAI's ChatGPT or Microsoft's Copilot. Nowadays, these chatbots can do a lot more than simply read text. But when I tried to use these AI tools to provide me with feedback on my videos, I found only Google's Gemini was actually able to review my YouTube videos. If I asked ChatGPT or Copilot to do the same thing, I'd get a message like this. So why can only Google Gemini do this? Well, that's a good question. So I asked Google Gemini, and this is what it said. I think it's simply that Gemini is a Google product and Google also owns YouTube. Gemini can directly access the videos. So how do we use Google Gemini? Head to Google Gemini's website. You'll need to sign into Gemini with your Google account. It won't work otherwise. You will also need to ensure the YouTube extension is enabled within Gemini. For me, it was already enabled, but here is how to check. The results I'll show you are from the free version of Gemini. There is a subscription-based Gemini Advanced, but I found for this specific use case that Gemini Advanced did not improve the quality of the summaries and the feedback that it provided. I first asked Gemini, can you analyze my YouTube video and provide feedback? And I gave the video URL. It quickly provided me with a summary of my video, but only a small critique at the end. I was looking for more detailed feedback, so I then went on and asked Gemini, what do you think I could do to improve this video? After receiving a response, you could modify it in a couple of ways. As you can see here, you can change the length. You can make it longer if you want more information, or shorter if it's too verbose, if it's too long. You can also change the style of the response, if that's relevant to you. One important finding was that when I repeated the question a few days later, Gemini provided me with a different summary. It didn't actually contradict itself, and in fact, the new answer was a better summary overall. But this is a good tip. If you're not happy with what you're provided, just try prompting Gemini again. Perhaps reword your prompt. See how you go. Next, I'll talk about the quality of Gemini's summary and its feedback on my video. So, how useful is Gemini really? I chose this video for Gemini to analyze as it was my longest video and includes a lot of detailed analysis as I described a game's performance on 5 different consoles, and I was keen to see how well Gemini tracked my analysis. I found Gemini was best at picking up the key points I'd made in my video, but Gemini also made more than a couple of errors in its summary, which you'd only know if you'd actually watched the video beforehand, or like me, if you'd actually made the video. Firstly, it got the title of my video wrong. And I gotta say, this isn't a good start. A 5-year-old would not have made that mistake. What's more, I don't know where it got this title from. Sometimes I do update video titles after I've published them, but I know I didn't change the title for this video as it's part of a series. It just seems an odd mistake to make, and it makes me wonder where Gemini's getting its information from. It then referred to me as the Ramnexus, which is nice, I guess, but it's my nom de plume is Ramnexus, just like Love Simple. Look it up. If the content of this video seems interesting to you, could I ask you to give me a like? That would be great. If you're interested in technical aspects of some older video games, perhaps check out my channel at Ramnexus and feel free to subscribe. What you are looking at now are the results that Gemini provided. In yellow are the areas where it's made a mistake. It says the game still looks good on the Xbox 360, but I definitely never said that. I love Oblivion, but it doesn't look good on the Xbox 360, which is why Microsoft spent so much time trying to make it look better. It also reports that I'd said the game runs in 1080p resolution on the Xbox One, but that is not correct. I didn't say that, and it doesn't. It runs at 600p, as I reported in the video.
On the Xbox One, with backwards compatibility, Oblivion still ran at only 600p and aimed at 30 frames a second.
It also says the Xbox One X version of Oblivion is the best way to play the game on consoles. I did not say that because it is not true. The summary also mentions that I reported Oblivion runs at 60 frames a second on the Xbox One X, which is also not true. It quite clearly runs at 30 frames a second.
Targeted frame rate for Oblivion on the Xbox One X, it's still 30 frames a second.
I measured it and showed the results of that. That's a very odd thing to say. It also summarized my video saying that the PC version of Oblivion is the best way to play the game. I did not say that in the video. The video was about how the different versions of the game run on the different consoles. I then asked a follow-on question. What do you think I could do to improve this video? It provided me with some suggestions, included gameplay footage and side-by-side comparisons, which I did do. It did suggest I talk about the improvement just on the 360, which didn't even cross my mind to do. And I probably wouldn't do it, but it is nice that it's given me advice that I hadn't considered. It suggested I talk about modding Oblivion on PC, which again is also a good idea, and I had thought of that. In fact, I collected footage, but I didn't include it because the video was long enough as it was. But yep, valid point. It suggested I include a summary table. Consider including a table at the end. What, like this one? Yeah, so I actually have a very clear summary table in the video. So what does that mean? It didn't know that I had one, or this is just generic advice? Yeah, it's also suggested that I include outro music to the video. What, you mean like this?
Ramnexus out.
And I just don't quite understand how it could not know that there was outro music in my video. It's just interesting the mistakes it makes and why it made those mistakes. What I am showing you is Gemini's response the first time I asked it to analyze my video. Its responses did seem to include fewer errors when I re-asked the same question a few days later, though each response it gave did still contain some errors. But I think it's important not to generalize Gemini's overall performance based on this single example. Google makes it clear that Gemini may display inaccurate information. Yep, and never a more true statement had been made. This is an important limitation to understand. If you're planning to use this tool to summarize videos you've not watched, you may not know if Gemini had made an error or not. And that could be important if this summary is relevant for your work or for your studies. There is definitely a need for fact checking. I also had Gemini review a draft edit of this video, and future me will comment on that if there's anything interesting to find. Hi, present me here, previously known as future me. I just had Gemini analyze a draft of this video you're watching and provide advice on how to improve it. So I learned a couple of things. Firstly, it seems Gemini can only review publicly published videos. It can't view unlisted videos, even if I give it the video link. For those of you who don't know, you can upload a video to YouTube as unlisted, which means no one will find it in a search, but anyone can watch it if I provide them with a link to the video. Any person can watch it, but not Gemini, it seems. Gemini also requires the video to have a captions file, which is the file containing the subtitles that you might be reading right now. YouTube actually does a good job of auto-generating subtitles, and many YouTubers just use those. But I usually go in and tidy up the auto-generated captions, partly because I apparently have an accent, although maybe everyone else does, I don't know. Anyway, also because YouTube Analytics says that 30% of you watch my videos with subtitles on. So I think it makes sense to make sure the subtitles are correct. The main issue is auto-generated subtitles may result in errors in Gemini's video summaries. The auto captions don't contain any punctuation. So Gemini's semantic engine, its large language model that derives actual meaning from text, it will, I imagine, have a harder time working out what the maker means if there's no punctuation. So what did Gemini say of this video? Well, here it is. I asked the same question with Gemini Free and Gemini Advanced. The analysis response from Gemini Advanced was a bit longer this time and listed at the end four key points from the video, which I think are actually spot on. They're really good. Gemini's response to my prompt for advice on improving the video was the same for the free and the advanced versions. What's more, the advice seems generic and not based on the content of my video, which might explain why it had suggested outro music to me previously. It seems Gemini isn't providing advice specific to this video, although it had when I asked the same question of previous videos. The problem is it doesn't tell you whether it's generic or specific advice. And this is an important take-home message and may reduce the usefulness of Gemini for content creators, unfortunately. Right, let's move on. A quick note on tone. The responses from Gemini, from ChatGPT, and from Copilot all seem to include a lot of compliments and used a lot of encouraging words. If we couple that with the messages being put forward in their advertising, I think the developers are keen for us to think of these systems in the same way we think about people. But it's a trick, and I think we all know this. The developers designed these systems to respond this way intentionally. If they were to give blunt criticism verging on insults, we just wouldn't use them. But what this means is we have responses that are wrong, but are said with such confidence that we might not know they're wrong. And that's, you know, that's how good liars lie. These AI tools are products that exist for their developers to make a profit. So of course they want to increase adoption as much as possible. And that's fair enough, but there seems to be a push to have us think about these systems' outputs in the same way we think about other people's output. But they're not people, and I make this point because it helps me understand how it can make the big errors it made. One reason you could see me in this video perplexed by the errors I saw is that I can't imagine how it made these errors. There's no transparency of its reasoning. If a person had written the responses I'd read, I'd conclude they just hadn't bothered to pay attention to the video when they were watching it before providing me with the feedback. And maybe that's the case here as well. Maybe Gemini just isn't good enough to do this job. Well, not yet, anyway. Google Gemini is a really interesting tool that can summarize YouTube videos and provide feedback to improve the quality. But beware, it isn't always accurate and some of its advice is very general. So always fact check and always test its suggestions. For me, it was a really good way to think about the content of my videos in a little bit of a different way. And that's always helpful. It gets me to step out of my comfort zone a little. Let me know how you might use this tool. Thank you very much for watching. If you really like the content of this video, I'm keen to hear back from you, definitely, because this is a new type of video for me. I'd like feedback from a human, someone who actually can read the title of the video. Okay, thanks for watching. Cheers. Ramnexus out.